star finish signals the game engine to move on to the next scene file under the scene list. If there are no more scenes, the game engine will show the default choices of play again or play more games like this, etc. Another way to move on to a different scene file is to call it directly using star go to underscore scene. Just make sure the scene file exists physically and add it to the scene list in the startup file. It is not required that you divide up the game into multiple scene files. You can put everything in startup.txt and make spell checking or search and replace operations easy. But for a long game, the text wall might become harder to read through when you're trying to find an error in the code. In my example, I will keep story content out of startup.txt and divide them into four scene files, starting with beginning.txt. A scene file can have more than one multiple choice group, represented by star choice. Then the wording of that choice, indicated by the pound sign, will be indented once for each one that's associated with this group. An indent can be any number of two or more spaces, as long as you are consistent with that amount. Each choice can then be followed by some optional text that describes the immediate outcome of making that choice, which is visible to the player. Notice that this text is further indented underneath the choice text. You can also optionally change the value of a variable that you have created earlier for the purpose of keeping track of progress. It has the same amount of indent as the outcome text. This variable will not be visible to the player unless you specifically show it in the stats screen, which is a topic for later. The only thing that's not optional for each choice line is the code that tells the engine where to go next. It can be either the simple star finish, which says to go to the next scene file in sequence, or star go to underscore scene to jump to a specific scene file, or star go to jump to another part of the same scene file. Star go to code syntax requires a label counterpart. Here I name the label post game and then starts a separate line with star label space post game. This new block of text does not have any indentation. It's as if I'm starting over from the top of this file. Once I pause the story with another star choice, then I add indent to the individual choices within that group, and the pattern repeats. If you are a writer, think of this as making a new index card for outlining the story. Sometimes you need to do it simply because the parent index card ran out of room. When you use star go to or star go to underscore scene, remember to write the destination part, be it a block of text with a label or a scene file. If you plan to add a new scene file, also add that name to star scene underscore list in the startup.txt file. You don't need any additional scene files. Everything can fit in startup.txt, but if you do add more, they can be named anything sensible, such as chapter 1, C1, or part 1, and so on.